Abraham Lincoln was the 16th president of the United States, a pivotal figure in American history. He led the country through a very difficult time, the Civil War, which lasted from 1861 to 1865. The Civil War was a fight between the North, known as the Union, and the South, known as the Confederacy. The South wanted to leave the United States and become its own country, primarily to preserve the institution of slavery. Lincoln fought tirelessly to keep the country together, believing that a divided nation could not stand. The war was long and bloody, with numerous battles resulting in heavy casualties on both sides. Many people died on both sides, with estimates of over 600,000 soldiers losing their lives. In 1865, after 4 years of intense fighting, the North won the war. The South surrendered and the country was reunited, marking the end of the Confederacy. Lincoln was a great leader, known for his eloquence and determination, but not everyone agreed with him. Some people in the South hated him, viewing him as a tyrant who threatened their way of life. They were angry that he was ending slavery, a cornerstone of the Southern economy and society. These people wanted to keep slavery, even if it meant destroying the country and its unity. In their desperation, they decided to take drastic action, leading to one of the most tragic events in American history. John Wilkes Booth was a famous actor, known for his charismatic performances on stage. He was also a staunch Confederate sympathizer, deeply invested in the Southern cause. This meant he supported the South in the Civil War, believing in their fight for independence and way of life. Booth was a passionate man, driven by his convictions and a fervent belief in his ideals. He believed strongly in the cause of the Confederacy, seeing it as a noble struggle against Northern aggression. He was devastated by the South's defeat, feeling a profound sense of loss and betrayal. Booth was not alone in his despair. He had a group of friends who shared his anger and disillusionment with the outcome of the war. They met in secret to discuss their feelings and plot their next moves, driven by a shared sense of purpose. The group included men like George Atzerodt, Lewis Powell, and David Harold, each with their own reasons for joining the cause. They were willing to do anything to avenge the South, even if it meant risking their lives and reputations. As Booth and his associates talked, their anger grew. They decided to take revenge on Lincoln. Their plan was deadly. They would kill Lincoln and other leaders. They hoped to create chaos and give the South a chance to rise again. Booth, a skilled actor, knew Ford's Theater well. He learned that Lincoln planned to attend a play there. It was the perfect opportunity. The date was set April 14, 1865. On that night, Booth and his co-conspirators would launch their attack. Section 4, The Fateful Night at Ford's Theater. On April 14, 1865, President Abraham Lincoln went to Ford's Theater. It was a cool spring evening, and the president was looking forward to a night of relaxation and entertainment. He was there to see a popular play called Our American Cousin, a comedy that had been drawing large crowds. Lincoln was sitting in his private box with his wife, Mary Todd Lincoln, and their guests, Major Henry Rathbone and Clara Harris. Unbeknownst to them, John Wilkes Booth, a well-known actor and Confederate sympathizer, was plotting a sinister act. Booth snuck up to the box, armed with a Derringer pistol. He shot Lincoln in the back of the head, a moment that would forever change American history. The audience gasped in horror as the sound of the gunshot echoed through the theater. Booth then leaped from the box onto the stage, breaking his leg in the process, but still managing to shout his infamous words. He shouted, "Sic semper tyrannis," which means "thus always to tyrants." This phrase, steeped in historical significance, was meant to justify his actions. Despite his injury, Booth managed to escape into the night, setting off a massive manhunt that would last for days. Section 5, The Aftermath and Manhunt. The country was in shock. Lincoln, their beloved leader, was dead. People mourned the loss of their president. The government launched a massive manhunt for Booth. They wanted to bring him to justice. After 12 days, soldiers found Booth hiding in a barn. He refused to surrender. The soldiers set the barn on fire and Booth was shot and killed. The other conspirators were also captured and punished. Section 6, Lincoln's Enduring Legacy. Abraham Lincoln's assassination was a tragedy for the nation. It was a blow to the hopes of healing after the Civil War. Lincoln is remembered as one of the greatest presidents in American history. He is honored for his leadership during the Civil War. He is also remembered for his role in ending slavery. Lincoln's legacy continues to inspire people today. He is a symbol of freedom, unity, and democracy.